The second offence is the offence of extortion. Extortion is dealt in sections 383 to 389 of the Indian Penal Code. Section 383 defines extortion as intentionally putting a person in fear of any injury to that person or any other person and thereby dishonestly inducing that person to deliver to any person property or valuable security or anything which can be converted into valuable security. Person accused of extortion can be punished with imprisonment up to 3 years or fine or with both. Now, two aspects require clarity in discussing the offence of extortion. Like, one is what is fear of injury and second is what amounts to delivery of property or valuable security. First, what is fear of injury? Fear of injury can be to the victim or to any other person. It need not be to the victim alone. To constitute fear of injury, the danger to the victim or to any person has to be real. It should not be imaginary. So, for causing, if someone says that or if someone puts pressure on a person to deliver valuable security, because if he does not deliver it, there will be a divine displeasure because gods would be angry. That does not amount to fear, because there is no fear, there is no fear of imminent danger to his person or to a person of another person, of anyone else. So, fear of injury can be physical injury or it can be injury to character if someone threatens a person of defamation unless and until that person delivers a property. Or it can be fear of criminal prosecution, and that fear can be, I mean, that criminal prosecution might be true or false. Even if you commit extortion by telling a person or by threatening a person that you will prosecute him, however legitimately it might be, unless and until that person delivers a property, that amounts to extortion. Now, second element is that there should be inducement for delivery of property. Now, inducement delivery means that there should be actual delivery of property. Now, here the offence of extortion is different from the offence of theft, because here property need not be only movable property, it can be immovable property also. So, there should be inducement to deliver the property. If the accused has only taken a thumb impression without any delivery or possibility of delivery of property, then that does not amount to extortion. Now, the case where it was held that extortion can be for immovable property also is Hyderabad State versus Birappa Moily, which was actually under the Hyderabad Penal Code. Section 319 of the Hyderabad Penal Code, which is similar to Section 383 of Indian Penal Code. Now, in this case, the accused was charged with offence of riots and extortion by threatening the person of dire consequences, so that he may deliver his shares as in a particular company as well as immovable property which belonged to his mother, now, or which he had got from his mother's side. Now, in this case it was held that it was extortion, because the defense that was taken was that here there is no delivery because it is an immovable property. And there cannot be a delivery of immovable property, but the court held that the word delivery in English language includes delivery or giving of both movable as well as immovable property. Now, how is extortion different from theft and cheating? One difference we have seen that theft can be only of movable property, while extortion can be of movable as well as immovable property. Now, in theft, property is taken without the consent of the victim. In extortion, the victim is made to deliver the property under fear of injury. Extortion is different from cheating, because in cheating, consent of the victim is taken, although fraudulently. Third offense is the offense of robbery. In all robbery, there is either theft or extortion. Theft becomes robbery when the purpose of committing theft or in the process of theft or in carrying away or attempting to carry away property obtained by theft, the accused causes or attempts to cause death, hurt or wrongful restraint or fear of instant occurrence of any of the three. Extortion becomes robbery when offender is in the presence of the accused at the time of commission of the offense and the victim is put in fear of instant death, instant hurt or instant wrongful restraint either for himself or some other person, and in this way offender induces the victim to deliver the thing extorted. The offender can be said to be present if he is sufficiently near to put the other person in fear of instant death, of instant hurt or of instant wrongful restraint. Robbery under the Indian Penal Code is punishable with rigorous imprisonment which may extend up to 10 years and fine. If robbery is committed on the highway between sunset and sunrise, imprisonment may extend up to 14 years. Now, in Harish Chandra versus State of UP, it was a small case of robbery where a person was traveling by a train and two persons boarded that train. When the train reached a particular platform and was going to stop, one of the two persons who had boarded the train later on snatched a wristwatch from the victim. The victim tried to raise an alarm and to take back the watch from the person who had taken it. To prevent him from doing so, the other person slapped the victim and pushed him. Later on, when the two offenders were caught, their defense was that it is not robbery because when the victim was slapped and pushed, at that time the wristwatch was already taken. So, the watch was not, the slapping or hurting the victim was not during the taking of the wristwatch. So, it does not amount to robbery. But the court did not accept this defense and it held that hurt was caused when the accused were trying to carry away the stolen property and because the victim had raised an alarm, he was slapped so that the accused may be able to carry away the stolen property. Therefore, it clearly amounted to robbery. Robbery becomes dacoity when it is committed by five or more persons conjointly with a common intention. Dacoity is also called gang robbery. Dacoity is punishable with imprisonment up to 10 years and fine. There are other punishments given for robbery there are other punishments given for robbery or dacoity committed under different circumstances. An illustrative or famous case of dacoity is Om Prakash versus State of UP, where nine armed persons entered or broke into a house in the night. They severely assaulted the master of the house, who, as a result of those injuries and assault, he died. They also assaulted his wife and brother-in-law and ran away with ornaments, cash and clothes. All of them were held liable under section 396 for robbery. So, this way the offenses for theft and extortion and robbery, they basically provided under the Indian Penal Code, they are basically there to ensure that state discharges its responsibility of protection of property of citizens. An important job of the state is to protect the person and property of the individuals or the persons or the life or property of the individuals residing within its territorial jurisdiction. So, it is the duty of the state to punish whoever illegally interferes in the enjoyment, use, ownership, use or enjoyment of the property of individuals. So, in this way, by providing punishments of various degrees depending on the seriousness of the offenses concerned, The state protects the property of the individuals residing within its jurisdiction and thereby discharges its duty. Thank you.